Memories of pleasure and pain sweep gently through the air, swirling through open windows and spread across the land, carried by the invisible midnight breeze. This silent intensity of night falls upon sleepless eyes. In the dark, the mind presents a wish, a feeling, a desire, an endless longing. Will there really be a morning? As the shadows conclude their provocative ballet, a spark, then a flash, then a glow, and then a flame. As quickly as it has ceased, the first light of a new day begins to conquer the sky. Glistening dawn has arrived. The air is so fresh that it already feels like a celebration. With the new day comes the chance for new life. Endless possibilities exist in this world of beginnings and endings.
The quick glance, the beginnings of a smile, the nervous caress of hair, the fluttering in the stomach and the clumsy fumbling of carefully planned words. It matters not. The eyes always speak the truth with flawless precision, often without intention. Where two beings exist, so can love. Love, in all of its perfect messiness. In its springtime, love blossoms through brilliant color that has never existed. Blue, that is color that is cooler than the deepest sea. Gold, that glows like the ancient sun. Purple, more rich and intoxicating than the ocean of lilac. The eyes of a lover are seeing the earth for the first time. The temple of the eyes is lit by love's radiance. How easily the days begin to pass. In every moment, there exists the steady undercurrent of the strong beating of two hearts. The rhythm runs through the ground and into the bedrock, while at the same time lifts up and dances on the clouds. Life becomes a sweet and unconscious blur. And then one day, the first flurries of love's winter touch down. A broken promise, a blind exchange of words with sharp edges. Eyes that were once ablaze are now extinguished, worn by a flood of tears. Loss occurs in many forms in nature. Loss can be as immediate and brutal as a tidal wave, or can be the slow erosion of million years of droplets. Loss can be the withering of love or the sudden taking of it. Loss leaves a scar, but the scar is a reminder that there was once love, and where there once was, can there will be. In love, we are alone, but never alone. We fear, but are never afraid. Where two beings exist, so will love.
Thank you.
drone that the planet hums softly, a melody far older and wiser, even than the eternal beating of time. With eyes closed and hearts open, we hear the words to her song. She speaks to us in the rustling of leaves, the whisper of wind, the ebb and flow of the seas. Her voice rings out over the mountains and across the plains. It glides smoothly over crystalline water. In a dense forest, it becomes a chorus, a cacophony of sounds, a dance of life and death. From womb to tomb, everything that lives is bound to our collective mother, the earth. She is both everywhere and nowhere, all-knowing and memory-less. We go to her when the pressures of the modern world are too overbearing. In her embrace, we find solace. Only the blue sky and gloomy woods know the sorrow and pain I am concealing. When we ache at the falling of the final rose petal, she comforts us. Shed no tear, for the flower will bloom another year. We take and we take, day in and day out. We incur a debt to nature. Perhaps there will come a day when the ledger must be clear and the debt repaid. Decomposition gives way to new growth. The circle of motion will continue forever. She was here before us and will be here long after us. And spring herself, when she woke at dawn, might scarcely know that we were gone. danced in the moonlight, swirling under the stars, caressed by the intoxicating summer air. I have run through a field at night, lifting from the ground until my soul is in flight. I have felt the warmth of morning's first light on my face, as gentle and as radiant as my mother's smile. The birds have fluttered just outside my window. I heard them singing faintly, their joyful melodies occasionally interrupted by the metallic grind of the machine from far beyond. In the springtime, I would lie in the shade of the willow tree with my face in the grass. The earth seemed to breathe with me. I could hear and feel the ground moving around my outstretched and careless arms. Soon, everything will be different again. The singing of the birds will be but a faint echo in my mind. I will cry for the light when the day is done, as the friendly blur of summer is replaced by the dark and solemn winter. The memories of soft grass touching my skin and the easy breeze running through my hair will serve only as bittersweet reminders of the brevity and nature of a life in flux. Nothing will last forever. Even the ancient sands that have carried the footsteps of every generation will one day turn to dust and then simply be gone. In these truths, perhaps, lies the answer that we have been searching for. I know that the timid assuredness of the darkest night will always be defeated by the promise of morning. The iciest of fallen tears will evaporate in the wake of two hearts on fire. The sting of death will never overcome the bliss of joy and life. Oh, how wonderful life is because nothing lasts forever. Imperfection is what makes us perfect. And perhaps the cycles of our lives are what gives life itself meaning. Tomorrow I will dance in the rain without a care in the world. I will laugh harder than ever before until my stomach is in knots and my tears are rolling down my face. I will love and trust more deeply. I will spread kindness. And when I close my eyes and drift away, I will smile and be thankful for the cycles of this perfectly imperfect life.
Oh, Good evening. Thank you all so much for joining us tonight. We have just a few more songs and then we'll be out of here. I haven't really prepared much for this moment right here. Instead, my thoughts and feelings and ideas about the performance were actually coming out in the readings that you heard earlier. First off, can we please give one more round of applause to our student readers? First was Ava Perryman and Tristan Cathcart, Alona Lutzik, and Lily Korn. Round of applause for us four. Concept of a program like this, it's kind of hard to know exactly what the right answer is or exactly how to put into words the things that we all feel and we all understand about the different cycles of our life, whether it be the earth or our relationships or the life cycle and unfortunately the death cycle as well. But I hope tonight, as you are experiencing the music and then the readings, the transitions, the aesthetic of the evening, I hope you were able to immerse yourself into the performance and have it be something more than just a choir concert for you personally. That is kind of what we try to do every time we come out here. So I truly hope you've enjoyed tonight's performance. We have one more tonight and then some other fun things that are gonna happen in a bit, including elephant sounds and crickets and other things, so stay tuned for that. Thank you once again.
Here and we're going to celebrate them with a special piece of music as well as hand out some senior awards. So if you'll give us just a second to get that process set up, we will move forward with the next part of our program.
Thank you. This is the sound of one voice, one spirit, one voice, someone who makes a choice. This is the sound of one voice. This is the sound of
Okay, so this is the time in the year where we like to honor our senior leadership. These are students who have put in 3 to 4 years with us, working hard, doing everything we ask them to do, putting in extra time, and generally just creating a climate and culture that is positive for those that will come after them. And we want to take a moment to tell them how special they are to us and what they mean to us. So we're going to start with the Director's Choice Award. This is an optional one. We don't give it every year. We only give it when we have senior classes that we feel like have those people who are deserving of awards beyond what we have available every year. And so this is one that we have chosen to give this year because we thought we had two individuals that were very deserving. So the description, the technical description of the award is that the Director's Choice is given to any student that achieves the highest level of musicianship, leadership, and citizenship, which is unrivaled by most other students, past, present, and future. These qualities perfectly embody the winners this year. They are always present, always prepared, and always on task during rehearsal. They possess a level of focus that makes them leaders who operate far beyond their age. They actually remind me a lot more of the musicians I encounter in the professional choir that Mr. Gately and I sing in, rather than a high school ensemble. Because of this, we lean on them for their musical leadership, and it's incredibly noticeable when they're absent. We can sing the first chord of a rehearsal and look at each other and say, why don't this choir sound like they normally do? And then we'll notice that one of them is gone. We're like, oh, that's why. So it's those kind of voices that we're talking about. The level of responsibility and pressure can be stressful for students who shoulder this type of students like these are expected to perform at the highest level every minute of every rehearsal. When they do make mistakes, which is rare, oftentimes the whole section will turn around and be like, why aren't you perfect all the time? Which can be tough. But these two singers never complain. They never give in to apathy, laziness, or complacency. They continue to show up every day and lead their sections with accuracy, passion, and commitment to the greater goal we aim to achieve in choir. These two students have been an essential part of the success of the OHS choir program over the past few years, and their presence will be greatly missed when they graduate. I'm honored to present the Director's Choice Award to Amber Martin and Isaac Lane. A separate award at our school, school-wide senior awards that were held in the gym a few days back. But I do want to recognize them because they don't give us much time to speak specifically about the students of those awards. So this is called the Choral Departmental Award. It's given to 2 choir students every year who have dedicated an immense amount of time, energy, and talent to the OHS choral program. This year's winners have excelled in each of these areas. Our winning young man is quite a character. He brings light and positivity to every situation he encounters, and he is a joy to teach every day. In every competitive event he's participated in this year, he's been one of the most independently prepared and most musically expressive singers we've sent. As a result, he was chosen as an alternate for the Missouri All-State Choir and took multiple events to state solo and ensemble contests. But more than that, he is constantly surprising us with funny shenanigans or inspiring speeches. He has entertained us while dressed head to toe in a suit made of pictures of his own face. And he's traveled to every Ozark elementary school and spoken with poise and passion about what choir means to him and the power of music to help young people grow into the best versions of themselves that they can possibly be. He is a student I will truly miss next year, both musically and personally. The young woman that receives our departmental award this year is going to be tough to talk about. She has overcome some very difficult obstacles in her life, but has never used them as an excuse to be anyone except an exceptional human being and musician. I don't think I've ever relied so heavily on a student before, from everything from leading sectionals, to planning social events, to singing way too many national anthems, to running the day-to-day of our program. She is always by my side, ready to help me with anything I could ask of her. She's actually in 3 of our 4 choirs this year, and if she could sing tenor, she'd probably be in men's chorus as well. I truly have never seen someone who brings this level of passion and commitment to our program. She takes the label of choir kid very seriously and is proud to represent our school through her musical gifts and leadership roles. I could discuss how talented she is, taking home the most gold ratings at state that a singer can receive. But honestly, the accolades are nothing compared to who she is as a person and what she has meant to our program and to us personally. We are suffering a great loss this year and one that I believe cannot be replaced. I'm very honored to present the Choral Departmental Awards to Gavin Robertson and Lily Kaur.
Thank you. Good evening. I am Danielle Monsanto, and this is, oh, where did she go? She's over there. That's Alicia Campbell. Some of you may know me as one of our current middle school counselors, but before I was in that role, I was a choir teacher and music teacher in the district for 9 or 10 years, and some of these kiddos that are seniors were my last group of choir kids. Ms. Campbell is our junior high choir teacher, and we actually started in the district the same year. Tonight, we are here to honor one student with an award that's particularly close to our hearts. We are going to give away the first ever Andrew Barnwell Memorial Scholarship. Andrew is a previous student that we both had the opportunity to work with. He is kind of one of your once-in-a-lifetime kids to work with. He passed away, sadly, a little over a year ago after a quite difficult and long battle with cancer. And so after his passing, some of us that used to teach him in choir really felt like we wanted to coordinate with his family and do something special in his honor. And so we have established a scholarship in his name. Andrew was a servant leader. He was always dependable. He was not your kid that was out in front, you know, center of the show, but he was always there. He was always dedicated. He had an incredible talent and a real special heart for choir in general. I think I got the honor of being one of his first choir teachers in fifth grade, and he continued all the way through his high school years. And so we're very excited to present this in his honor this evening.
Once again, this is a scholarship, Andrew Barnwell Memorial Scholarship. His parents and family are here, and I can't see them because it's very dark, but if you guys will stand, that would be great. So everybody else can see you. Had them fill out the application, and so the Barnwells got to read over those just like we all did, and as they were reading, they felt like all of the scholarship applications were really wonderful, but there was one that really stuck out to them. As they were reading, they thought, this is the one that sounds like and seems to embody all of those qualities that made Andrew Andrew. So this year, our first Andrew Barnwell Memorial Scholarship is going to go to Mr. Gavin Roberts.
Thank you. Just a few more awards, and then we will get going with the elephant noises and all that. The final award for tonight, or I should say, second to final, the National School Choral Award is one of the highest honors of all high school choral performers. It recognizes the dedication and musical achievement of two of the top performing students in the entire program. This year, Ms. Brammer and I are delighted to announce Will Elliott and Andrea Schuford as the recipients. Beyond what we just do at Ozark High School, Will and Andrea have consistently gone above and beyond to challenge themselves for the entirety of their time as singers in our program. Both students have been repeated members of the Missouri All-District Honor Choir and have been ranked within the top 25 of their individual voice parts in previous auditions. Will auditioned and was selected this year to be a member of 2023 Missouri All-State Choir, which is considered across the country as one of the finest high school choral honor ensembles. Both students have earned gold and silver medals at the district and state level as soloists and ensemble members. Both students have plans to continue singing at the collegiate level after graduation. Beyond their impressive accomplishments outside of the classroom, these two have been crucial members of our program for years. They work extremely hard and through their work inspire others to achieve more. They show up and give their best no matter what. They are beloved by their peers and will be leaving behind a legacy of excellence, kindness, and friendship. We will miss them dearly, but know that this is only a chapter in the story of what is going to be two incredible lives. It is my pleasure to award the 2023 National School Choral Award to Will Elliott and Andrea Schuford. I At this time, I'd like to invite the rest of the choral students up to the stage for the fun.
Any alumni that are in the audience, you know what this is. So if you want to be a part of it, you are more than welcome. Come on up.
Front and center, $100. I've got $100 in my wallet. I got it right here. I'm on the table. Because you got to stand right in the middle. It's got to be right in the middle. It's just the Sean's smile. Pretty much. All the $100 right here. If I lose your watch, then he knows why you got it. Maybe next time. Actually, she's done a really good
up here. I have actually one more award that I need to talk about in just a moment. The class awards was something that Ms. Brammer and I began last year as a way for the students of each class to recognize their peers for their achievements, as described on the forms that the students filled out. The class award is not based simply on musical or vocal talents, but instead on personality, leadership, work ethic, and kindness. The winner should be someone that comes to class every day, always has their materials, always works hard in rehearsal, helps lead others in their section, and positively contributes to the culture and climate of both the class and the school program as a whole. Each student in every class had the opportunity to pick someone who they believed was deserving of the award and provide reasons for why they think that person should be chosen. I was blown away by the responses that were given. For the sake of time, I can't share any right now, but it's very clear to me just how appreciated and loved that all of these recipients are by their classmates. They have been leaders in their classes all year long and are going to continue to do great things for our program and beyond in the future. The four class award winners, please hold your applause until all four. From Women's Chorus, Ella Kozlov. From Men's Chorus, Grayson Buckner. From Advanced Women's Chorus, Cammie Dyke. And Chorale, Sophie Hall. I have the thing, but they can't get it right now because they're squished.